Change your heart, Lord, change our heart. You're living in a lawful way. Be mindful of what you say. Be sincere when you pray. Today could be your last day. Bear each other no malice. Greed and faith can coexist in the same heart.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen. Nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome to another episode of the Gems of the Heart, this beautiful program that I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless it for us. Something that we discuss in it, the most beautiful thing ever, and that is the names and attributes of Allah. Just in this part of the program, this is intended to be something that we talk about what purify our hearts. And there's nothing more important, more beautiful, than to talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the purifier of the hearts. And if you remember months ago, that when we started this program is about the belief, the matter of belief, to start with matters of aqidah, matters of belief, and how can that purify our hearts? How can we purify our hearts and elevate ourselves with first the foundation of this religion, which is matters of belief? And we're still in the first pillar of al-Iman, the first pillar of faith, which is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we start talking about the names and attributes of Allah. And this is a subject that really, once you start talking about it, you don't want to move to another topic, because there's nothing more beautiful than to talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and earth. And the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has great effect to our hearts if we really believe in them in the right way. And then to try to implement the effect and the outcome and the implications of believing in them in our hearts. When people think of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not something to be said many times or to be used in specific ways of saying dhikr. And actually, we have to follow the sunnah, the way the Prophet ﷺ. And some people, they would repeat the same name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over and over again, when the Prophet ﷺ never done such a thing. And it doesn't matter whether a person feels this way or that way, we have to follow the way of the Prophet ﷺ in all of our affairs, whether it's matters of belief or matters of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and so on. Inshallah ta'ala, in this episode, we'll talk about one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as it's been throughout many episodes before. And today, inshallah ta'ala, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ash-Shaheed. The name Ash-Shaheed. And the name Ash-Shaheed means the witness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness over all things. And how is that mentioned in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ? How can we benefit from this to purify our hearts with this beautiful name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ash-Shaheed? First of all, what does it mean? What does it mean, the name Ash-Shaheed? What does it mean? It means the one that nothing whatsoever would be away from his knowledge and his witness. When you see someone witnessing something, that means he see it with his own eyes, he knows exactly what's happening. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a shaheed over all things. He's the creator of all things, so he is the witness. And there are great meanings, as we would see inshallah ta'ala. When we see the word shahada or witnessing, many times it's used in the court of law. When someone claims something, and they would ask him for evidence, or if you have witnesses, someone would say that, you know, accusing someone that he's a killer or whatever, then people have to come up with evidence that he killed, or witnesses, those who witnessed the act, and so on and so forth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a shaheed, is the one that is the best of all witnesses. He's the creator of the heavens and the earth. And therefore, as a fact of life in this earth that we live in, there are people that would be treated unjustly, and they will be accused unjustly, and they don't have any evidence or any witness to witness for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is their witness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best whether they are oppressed and treated with injustice or innocent, or whether they are evil and they are criminals and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. So anybody can say whatever they want. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness. That's why in the hereafter everything will be exposed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffices for the believers that He is Ash-Shaheed subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the knower of all things, and He sees all things, and He witnesses for all things, then this is something that has to bring the tranquility and peace and the contentment in the hearts of the believers. And this is the purification of the soul. This is how we purify ourselves when we get to know the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's look into the Quran and see how this attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned in the Quran. When people start to deviate from the truth, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a messenger, and some people believe, some people disbelieve, Allah is the one that witnessed over all of this. And when people after the messengers of Allah deviate from the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ash-Shaheed, is the one that is witnessing what they're doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in Surah Al-Imran, verse number 98, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians, and why they disbelieve after the matter has been made clear to them. Why they disbelieved in Jesus, the son of Mary, when he was sent to them from Bani Israel. Why when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to them, and sent to all mankind, they disbelieved. Why did they associate partners with Allah? All of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding them. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لِمَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ شَهِيدٌ عَلَى مَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Such a powerful verse that reminds the people of the book and remind us also ourselves that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O people of the book, why you disbelieve in the ayat of Allah, the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shaheedun, that's the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the witness over what you do. So therefore, people can deny things, people can claim things, but if they have the true fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing them, is seeing what's in the hearts. They cannot lie, meaning that lie would never avail them, never benefit them, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the witness, He is the one that is seeing them. So it's a call for the people of the book, those who have sincerity, those who are truthful, if they want to follow the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing you. Don't deceive yourself, don't deceive others because of manipulation, because of power, because of wealth, or whatever there is. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that about them in the Quran. يا الذين آمنوا إن كثيرا من الأحبار والرهبان لا يأكلون أموال الناس بالباطل ويصدون عن سبيل الله. That all you who believe among the monks and the priests are those who would take the money of the people in an unjust way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing over them. He knows who's taking what for what reason. And the same thing for a Muslim. Everything that we do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness, is the one that witness over all things. So this is how that should purify our hearts, would make a person aware of that. When we're buying and selling, you might deceive the one that you sell him your product. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witness. How we are in so much in need of witnesses when we have a contract. Why? Because when it's time of disputes or whatever there is, everything is witnessed. And with all the conditions and so on and so forth. But to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, above all, He is the one that is witnessing all of this. And if people have the fear of Allah, they would fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost, and they would never betray others. And that's the real purification of the soul. When some of the early generations of Islam, he was asked to write a book about zuhd, about abstinence of matters of this world, something that, you know, when people have purification of the hearts, they're not attached to the materialistic things of this world. He said, I did. صَنَّفْتُ كِتَابًا فِي الْبُيُوعِ. That means I made a book in transactions, in buying and selling. Why? Because if people have the fear of Allah, if they have their hearts not attached to this world and attached to the hereafter, they would fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in buying and selling. They won't take the money of others in a betrayal way. They won't lie in their buying and selling. They won't cheat others and so on. That's the effect of knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His names and attributes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that witness over all things. Every single action is done on the face of earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing over that. And people will be brought to the justice of Allah, so they should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's a call for the evildoers to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing everything that they do and their plots and so on. And also a call for the believers to have tranquility in their hearts. If they are being treated unjustly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing all of this. And it would never continue to be in such a way forever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bring the matter to the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. It's a clear warning when a person is alone. And we are in need of this. When a person is alone and the whispers of shaitan and the evil thoughts comes into one's mind, and a person wants to commit a sin, and nobody is witnessing him, nobody can see him, to remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ash-Shaheed, is the all witness. He's witnessing exactly what you're doing at the moment that you're doing, whatever there is. He knows even the betrayal of the eyes. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُونِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the betrayal of the eyes. When a person steals a look, that is not permissible for him. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's best and what's inside of the hearts of the people. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this matter in more than one verse, and how that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the final messenger of Allah. And there is no need of many of the evidences, even though the matter is very clear, because there is nothing better than the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a shaheed, is the one that is witness, is the witness over the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As it's mentioned in Surah An-Nisa, verse number 79, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ وَأَرْسَلْنَاكَ لِلنَّاسِ رَسُولًا وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. Which means, what comes to you of good is from Allah, but what comes to you of evil is from yourself. And we have sent down, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the people as a messenger, and sufficient is Allah as witness. And what this verse with the next verses and so on, it means that whenever goodness comes to you is from Allah. Whatever evil happens to you, even though it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as it's mentioned in the previous verse, but it means here the reason for the evil is because of your own self, your own shortcomings and so on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَرْسَلْنَاكَ لِلنَّاسِ رَسُولًا. We had sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as a messenger to all mankind. Then وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. Sufficient is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a witness. This is what makes it very clear that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is the final messenger of Allah. There is nothing more clearer than this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness that he is the messenger of Allah, with the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and with the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he sent the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, being the final messenger of Allah, he would say that in the Day of Judgment, and he would bring this into the people, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him as witness over all mankind, and he would witness over all things. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. But in Surah Al-Ma'idah, towards the end of the surah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask Isa, Jesus the son of Mary, about the false beliefs that the people attributed to him, and that he is the Lord, or he's the son of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the like of this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would ask Isa alayhi salam, and he would deny of course this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But one of the things that Isa alayhi salam, he would say, as it's mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 177, مَا قُلْتُ لَهُمْ إِلَّا مَا أَمَرْتَنِي بِهِ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Isa alayhi salam, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّي أَلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Did you say to the people to take you and your mother as ilahain, as gods to be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, مَا قُلْتُ لَهُمْ إِلَّا مَا أَمَرْتَنِي بِهِ. Part of the answer that he said, I did not say nothing to them except what you ordered me to say. أَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبَّكُمْ. That you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord and your Lord. وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ. Shaheedan, the same word is mentioned here. And I was a witness upon them, over them, as long as I was with them. فَلَمَّ تَوَفَّيْتَنِي كُنْتَ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَنْتَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. And then when you took me up, you were the observer over them, and you are over all things witness. So Isa alayhi salam, he's saying that, and he's saying that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that witness over all things. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, when he mentioned, as it's reported by Bukhari Muslim, he said, O people, that you will be gathered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّكُمْ مَحْشُرُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ حُفَاتًا عُرَاتًا غُرْلًا, that you will be gathered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala barefooted, naked, uncircumcised. So, and then he quoted a verse in the Quran, كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلْ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُ, that this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he promised that whatever the original creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, he would originate them, he would resurrect them again subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet ﷺ said the meaning of which, that the first of the creation of Allah that will be covered with dress and having clothed is Ibrahim alayhi salam. And then the Prophet ﷺ, he said, أَلَا وَإِنَّهُ يُجَاءُ بِرِجَالٍ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي, men among my ummah will be brought, فَيُؤْخَذُ بِهِمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ, they will be taken away to the left, and I would say, Ya Rabbi, Usayhabi, O my Lord, these are my friends or companions. So it will be said to the Prophet ﷺ, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَكَ, you do not know what they introduced after you, O Prophet ﷺ. So the Prophet ﷺ would say, and that's what I mentioned this for, so the Prophet ﷺ said, فَأَقُولُ كَمَا قَالَ الْعَبْدُ الصَّالِحِ, I would say then the same what the righteous slave of Allah said, referring to Isa alayhi salam in the verse that we just mentioned. وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ فَلَمَّا تَوْفَيْتَنِي كُنْتَ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَنْتَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ, I was a witness as long as I was with them, but when you took me up, when you took my soul, you are the one that is aware of them, an observer over them, and you are over all things witness. So the Prophet ﷺ would say that, and would say that in the Day of Judgment, as Isa alayhi salam said that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which shows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witness over all things. And when people would think, for example, at the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, people would, even when they do something that is not right or haram and so on, they know that the revelation from Allah is coming down and that can expose them. But after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the matter is still there, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that witness everything that we say and everything that we do. So a person, it is sufficient for the person to know that, to be obedient to Allah, to be steadfast upon the truth. And to, whether a person is alone or in front of people, this is what we need to implant in our hearts and the hearts of our generations to come. This is how to purify ourselves, to constantly be witnessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is hearing what we say. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us with His knowledge and power and so on. So that the person will be always watchful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making sure that what we say and what we do is always perfect and according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. And if a person is in a state of forgetfulness, slipped away, committed a sin and so on, he immediately repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very near to him. The best subject is the subject of the tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship. And that's why the evidence to the tawheed of Allah, to the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, isn't so much mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet. No excuse, so many evidences. The entire Quran is about the tawheed. The entire Quran is about the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But also, the best of all witnesses and the biggest witness whatsoever is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala witnessed for his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he's the final messenger of Allah. And this is something that is mentioned in Surah Al-An'am, verse number 19, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَةً قُلِ اللَّهِ شَهِيدٌ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ وَأُوحِيَ أَلَيَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لِأُنذِرَكُمْ بِهِ وَمَنْ بَلَغَ أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَشْهَدُونَ أَنَّ مَعَ اللَّهِ أَلِهَةً أُخْرَى قُلْ لَا أَشْهَدُ قُلْ إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنَّنِي بَرِيءٌ مِمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ, which means, قُلْ means say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what thing is greatest in testimony? قُلْ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَةً, what thing is greatest in testimony? قُلْ اللَّهِ, say, Allah is witness between me and you. وَأُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لِأُنذِرَكُمْ بِهِ وَمَنْ بَلَغَ, and the Quran has been revealed to me that I may warn you thereby and whomever it reaches. أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَشْهَدُونَ أَنَّ مَعَ اللَّهِ أَلِهَةً أُخْرَى, do you truly testify and witness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with him is other deities? قُلْ لَا أَشْهَد, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I don't witness that because there's no deity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنَّنِي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ, indeed is إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ, only one worthy of worship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I distance myself from what you associate partners with Allah. So this is a clear evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of all witnesses. And as Ibn Jarir and others, they said in the tafsir of the ayah, that say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to those mushrikeen, to those polytheists, the disbelievers, those who deny you and deny the truth that you brought to your people and to the world, who is the biggest or the best and the biggest witness? Then inform them that the biggest things whatsoever for witness is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that his shahada, his witness, can never be in a situation where it's not permissible, or in forgetfulness or lying and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that witnesses over all things. And as we see when we're reading some of these verses and how it's mentioned and how this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned and the meaning of it and significance of it is in such a way that we need to be constantly watchful of our speech and actions and not to allow ourselves to be in state of forgetfulness. So this is something that has to be part of our life, and this is how we purify our hearts, and that's how we benefit from what we hear. We'll be right back inshallah ta'ala. We'll take a short break, and after we come back with your phone calls and with your comments and so on, and continuing with the beautiful name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ash-Shaheed. So stay with us inshallah.
ضرب ابن مريم مثلا إذا قومك منه يصدون وقالوا أآلهتنا خير أم هو ما ضربوه لك إلا جدلا بل هم قوم خصمون
إن هو إلا عبد أنعمنا عليه وجعلناه مثلا لبني إسرائيل ولو نشاء لجعلنا منكم ملائكة في الأرض يخلفون
ما شاء الله. We have a young viewer. How old are you, Muhammad?
11.
ما شاء الله. Go ahead and recite from ayah number 10, فارتقب, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فارتقب يوم تأتي السماء بدخان مبين يرجى الناس هذا عذاب أليم ربنا اكشف عنا العذاب إنا مؤمنون
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فأسر بعبادي ليلا إنكم متبعون واترك البحر رهوا إنهم جند مغرقون كم تركوا من جنة جنات وعيون ودروع ومقام كريم
وتبارك الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما وعنده علم الساعة
span sent from Allah to an angel then to a man that man was Muhammad the best of creation
We are on air again glad tidings to Huda TV viewers worldwide for the resumption of live broadcasting on NowSat we are now broadcasting on the advanced DVB S2 system tune in using our new frequency 12188 horizontal on NowSat. Please note, you will need to have a modern HD receiver in order to tune in. Enjoy your favorite edutainment programs with crystal clear resolution, Hada TV, a light in every home.
Now that we know more about da'wah, what would you say are the characteristics of a da'i?
Sincerity.
Sincerity? Yes?
Good relation with Allah.
Good relation with Allah. Okay.
Patience.
Yes, sir?
Good manners.
Good manners. And there is much more to that. Join us in our program, the Da'wah Workshop, by your brother, Dr. Rayyan Fawzi Arab, so that we could talk more about da'wah exclusively on Huda TV.
Welcome back, and with the gems of the heart and the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ash-Shaheed, the witness, and the meaning of that and the benefit of it and how that can purify our hearts, and as all of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, something that we really need to get ourselves busy with. When we recite the Quran, we would get to see these attributes of Allah, and that's why we need to work with our hearts to benefit from it. The Quran is revealed for us to reflect upon it, for us to act according to it. And one of the great things that the Quran does to ourselves is to purify our hearts and to purify our souls, so that we would elevate ourselves and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with His names and attributes. We were mentioning some of the verses in the Quran that talks about the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ash-Shaheed, and how that the last thing that we mentioned, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of all witnesses over all matters, and especially with matters of the truth. And there are few verses in the Quran that talks about that meaning, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the disbelievers, they claim things and they say things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is over them, the witness subhanahu wa ta'ala, as it's mentioned, for example. And then we'll talk about the benefits, because we need to reflect upon really how can we benefit from knowing this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one of these verses in Surah Yunus, verse number 28, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَوْمَ نَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ نَقُولُ لِلَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا مَكَانَكُمْ أَنْتُمْ وَشُرَكَاؤُكُمْ فَزَيَّنَّا بَيْنَهُمْ وَقَالَ شُرَكَاؤُهُمْ مَا كُنْتُمْ إِيَّانَا تَعْبُدُونَ فَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ إِنْ كُنَّا عَنْ عِبَادَتِكُمْ لَغَافِلِينَ. Which means that on the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would resurrect them, and he would say to the polytheists, those associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَكَانَكُمْ أَنْتُمْ وَشُرَكَاؤُكُمْ, that means that you remain in your place, you and your partners. فَزَيَّنَّ بَيْنَهُمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will separate between both of them. وَقَالَ شُرَكَاؤُهُمْ مَا كُنْتُمْ إِيَّانَا تَعْبُدُونَ, the ones that they used to worship would say that you did not used to worship us, because they distanced themselves from them. فَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ إِن كُنَّا عَنْ عِبَادَتِكُمْ لَغَافِلِينَ. That which means, and sufficient is Allah as a witness between us and you that we were of your worship unaware. So the people would claim that they worshipped them, and they would even claim that they did so because they have been called to do so. So they would distance themselves away from them, and they would say that sufficient is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a witness between us and you. And therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the shaheed, is the witness. That's why, by the power of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would order the angels to write everything that the human being do. And what's the significance? Why is that? Why it's this way, even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that witnesses over all things. He does not need the angels to write down and to write all the actions of the people and so on. But it's by the justice of Allah, so that the human beings would see clearly that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of all witnesses, He's the one that witnesses all things. And this is something that, again, as we said, we would see clearly in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when the disbelievers, for example, they say to the Prophet ﷺ, ويقول الذين كفروا لست مرسلا, سورة الرعد, ويقول الذين كفروا لست مرسلا. The disbelievers would say that you are not a messenger of Allah. قل كفى بالله شهيدا بيني وبينكم ومن عنده علم الكتاب, which means that between you and you, between me and you is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness and the one that has the knowledge of the book and those who have the knowledge of the book. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is witnessing over this fact that I've been sent to you. And they know that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of all witnesses. And He's watching all of us. And people will be brought back to the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we see, this meaning is repeated throughout the entire Quran. As an example to that also, in Surah Al-Isra, verse number 96, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِعِبَادِي خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا. Which means that, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sufficient is Allah as witness between you and between me and you. قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ, between me and you. إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِعِبَادِي خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ever concerning His servants, acquainted and seeing. So when they would suggest things, the disbelievers, and they would try to say things that has no basis to it whatsoever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making the matter very clear to them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient, He is subhanahu wa ta'ala as a witness between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and them. And the disbelievers or the human beings, the human race, how much they are always and constantly in dispute with matters of belief and so on. The matter will be brought to the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter. And this is something clearly stated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hajj, verse number 17, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالصَّابِئِينَ وَالنَّصَارَ وَالْمَجُوسَ وَالَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَفْصِلُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. Indeed, those who have believed and those who were Jews and the Sabians and the Christians and the Magians and those who associated with Allah, Allah will judge between them on the day of resurrection. Indeed, Allah is over all things witness. So all of these different people, with everybody with their belief and everything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge between them. And He is the one that is all witness subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, all of these people on the face of earth, they should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And they should not deviate from the truth, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring them to the justice of Allah. And they know, if they have the knowledge, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent all of the messengers of Allah to call the people to the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why associate partners with Allah? Why not follow the messengers of Allah and the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice, He is subhanahu wa ta'ala for all matters of witnesses, because He is the Ash-Shaheed, He's the one that witnesses. As we said before, when people need someone to witness for them, to prove their case or so, and when human beings, sometimes they betray others, and that's why the shahada is a very serious matter. To be asked to witness in a matter, the person has to witness only on the things that he have seen clearly, like the same way that you would see the sun in a day that has no clouds and so on. How clear it is, this is how the witness should be. And a person should never, and this is not permissible in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that a person would witness over something that he didn't see just for the fact or because someone that he trusts so much, he have seen something. So a person would say, I witnessed that this person is a thief. He didn't see him stealing, but he's saying that based on the statement of a trustworthy person that he knows. That's not valid, this is not permissible. A person should only witness over the things that he saw with his own eyes, something that is no doubt whatsoever, even if he has no doubt, but he saw it clearly like you see the sun. That's why a person has to be careful, and at the same time, you know, witnessing what is right, and to make sure that a person has the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is all from the benefits of knowing and learning one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One last verse, and then we talk about some of the benefits because of the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Ankabut, verse number 52, قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ شَهِيدًا يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْبَاطِلِ وَكَفَرُوا بِاللَّهِ وَلَيْكُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Which means, say, sufficient is Allah between me and you as witness. He knows what's in the heavens and the earth, and they who have believed in falsehood and disbelieved in Allah, it is those who are the losers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enough and sufficient for the believers to be the one that witnesses over all things. قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ شَهِيدًا, as the previous verses. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows what's in the heavens and the earth. And those who believed in the falsehood and disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the losers. So the Prophet ﷺ has been ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the matter clear to the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing what they're saying. He's witnessing what they're doing and what they're claiming to be lies and so on, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in their hearts. And therefore, you know, this great name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would see how it brings the ta'zeem or the exaltness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hearts of the believers. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness over all things, that means a person has to have the exaltation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respecting the orders of Allah, knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing us at all times and witnessing what we're doing. Right? We don't need to be only righteous when we are in front of righteous people. If a person is with his friends, those who are not righteous, how does he act? Is he act the same as he would act if he's with people of knowledge or people of righteousness? It should be. He should be away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade. When a person is alone and he closed the door and there's nobody with him, and he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ash-Shaheed, and this is a matter of belief, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing him, that he's alone, and what is he going to do? And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, يَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَخَافُهُ بِالْغَيْبِ. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to know who fears Allah with the fact that it's unseen. So whether a person is alone or with people, he has the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a great benefit to this name, to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ash-Shaheed, is to have the fear of Allah, to exalt the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His names and attributes. Also one of these great benefits is to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the right way. Right? Because if a person knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching him, right, he would see it in a way that there's no such a thing as hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is nothing is hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So not just saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us, but to have this belief and to have this inside of us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing what we do, this is something that can be a life-changing. And it is a life-changing. So the Prophet ﷺ raised the companions radiallahu anhum with this matter, and that he made them have this belief in them, so they acted accordingly. Some people, they only are obedient to Allah when they are in front of people. Well, if they believe in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ash-Shaheed, and He's the one that is witnessing all of what they do, the life will change. But it's still a person, if he committed a sin, was weak, he should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a great benefit also. Another benefit is to show with the witness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over His creation, that leads us to many of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Makes us see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. And He's the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. Merciful towards the believers and just towards the disbelievers. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the perfect names and attributes. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not punish His creation based on His knowledge, but based on their own actions. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, but everything is left till they do their own actions so that they don't blame anyone but their own selves. And so this is a great meaning here, that how the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is given to the believers, and how the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is given to the disbelievers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would never treat anyone with injustice. We need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this name, Ash-Shaheed. We need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this has to do basically on the highest level of Al-Islam. The highest level in the religion of Al-Islam is this level of Al-Ihsan. And the level of Al-Ihsan is basically based on this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is witness, is the one that witness all things that we do. And the Prophet ﷺ said that Al-Ihsan, أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. That you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the fact of this life, people would see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter, but you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you, is witnessing over everything you do. So that takes a person to the level of Al-Ihsan. Our salah will be, whether we are alone or with the people, a person will work on himself to be the same, with humbleness, with goodness. If a person is alone, he won't do evil things because he's alone. But rather he would have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you are seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. And He is a witness over you. And it has more than just watching. Because a witness, that means it's in the context of a person do wrong, there's a witness. And the best of all witnesses, the one that would not forget, the one that would not be of any weak or deficiency, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a very serious matter. And we don't want to have the witness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against us. But rather for us, if we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these types of names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a beautiful one. And as Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, the famous story from him, that when he wanted to test one of the shepherds, and he had goats and sheep with him, and he said to him, you know, he wanted to take one of these goats and so on, and the man said, but this is not mine, this belongs to the one, the owner of this. He said, tell him that the wolf ate it, you know. And the man said, وَأَيْنَ اللَّهُ, and where is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, he had the fear of Allah. He knows that Allah is witnessing over him. He's not concerned about the money and how much money he would make. He's concerned about the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching him. So therefore, a person should care more about what is right and to stay away from what is wrong. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing. And that's why when a person is tested to see by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whether he will be steadfast and patient, or whether a person would follow his desires. That's why these tests and trials in our life, to see this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing us. And nothing will be wasted, because everything is by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a very serious matter also, that you know, people, when they look into, even when we look at our children, our families, and how this is a clear concept. The religion is not to be taught as only physical actions. Many people, they think that they have done their responsibility if they make the children pray as far as standing and ruku' and sujood, which is definitely, it's a duty upon the parents to make sure that their child learns how to make salah when they're 7 years old. As the Prophet ﷺ said, مُرُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَهُمْ أَبْنَاءُ سَبْعَ. Order your children to pray when they're 7 years old, even though they're not responsible for their actions yet, and they're not committing haram or a sin if they would miss the salah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the parents to make sure that their children, they pray when they're 7 years old, to get used to the matter so that they don't rebel against the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the point here is making them pray, taking them to memorize the entire Quran. It's a beautiful thing, and all kinds of struggle that the parents will go through and so on, those who are concerned about their children. But here another level, and that is to raise them to be watchful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing them. So if they do bad, they know that Allah is watching them and witnessing over them. And if a person intend to do good, it doesn't have to be with show off. A person who you would do good, and he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in his heart, and he would reward them the best rewards ever. So children being raised like this, that their fear is not from their parents necessarily, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have hope for the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If something that they missed in this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would replace it by something better for them, if they're obedient to Allah and patient and so on. And as we know that the famous example of the one that gathered his kids and children, and he wanted to test them, and he gave each one a stick, and he said, go somewhere and hide so that nobody would be able to see you whatsoever. They all dispersed, and they ran to the place where they would think that nobody would see them except one. And he asked them, why didn't you go with them? He said, there's no such a thing as a place where no one can see us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us, is seeing us. So this is basically the one that passed this test. He wanted to test them to see how true that is, that they have this in their hearts. So where is that in our life today? This has to be an essential part of our life. Before we go, why we're going? Before we, when we come home, what is our affairs? What's in our hearts? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in our hearts. We can deceive others. We can look like righteous. We can speak all kinds of good things in matters of the religion. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in our hearts. And that's why we have to be watchful of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witnessing not just over our physical actions, but over our intentions and the love of Allah and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts and so on. So this is something that if a person has this in himself, that's purification of the soul, purification of the heart. And that's why we need as Muslims to implement this in our hearts and to see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all witnessing over all things. If a disbeliever, if an evil person says whatever he says, Allah is witnessing over that. Don't worry, just be obedient to Allah. Be steadfast on the deen of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save us and make us among those who are righteous and those who would enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts and to make us among those who learn and benefit from the knowledge of that get them closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to make us among those who are under the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So till next time, I leave you with the protection of Allah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala Muhammadin wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
What you say, be sincere when you pray. Today could be your last day. Bear each other, no malice. Greed and faith can coexist in the same.